A warm welcome to my students. Social and religious reformation movement will be continued. In this session, I'm going to teach you four more concepts. As previously, we have learned about establishment of Brahmo Samaj and reformation in Bengal movement, establishment of Arya Samaj and reformations led by Prarthana Samaj, ideas of Satya Sodhaka Samaj, Aligarh movement. So these are the topics which I have completed in the previous session. Now in this session we will start Ramakrishna movement's ideologies, Theosophical Society, Sri Narayana Guru, Dharma Paripalana Yogam, Periyar. So these are the topics which we are going to learn in this session. So first we will learn about Ramakrishna movement. The most important person who was responsible for establishing Ramakrishna mission. Observe this picture. He is Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. But at the same time, you people have to remember, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa did not establish Ramakrishna mission. Ramakrishna mission was established by Swami Vivekananda at Belur near Calcutta in 1897. Ramakrishna Math was established at Mayavati near Uttaranchal. Ramakrishna mission has provided a unique contribution to India's spiritual growth, nationalistic awareness and culture development. So remember, Ramakrishna mission was founded by Swami Vivekananda. And this picture is Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Now we will learn detailly about Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was a worshipper of Kali and also was a priest at Calcutta Kali Mandir. And he believed that if one has to attain moksha, there are two ways to attain moksha: through dhyana and bhakti. This is a way where we can attain moksha. So Ramakrishna believed that through dhyana and bhakti we can attain moksha. He also believed that all religion advocated the same. He believed that there are many ways of attaining moksha and the God. He said idol worship is inevitable, that is, we cannot avoid worshipping idol worship. Now we will learn about Swami Vivekananda, who was a founder of Ramakrishna mission, who played a very important role in getting reformation in our country. Swami Vivekananda founded Ramakrishna mission at Belur near Calcutta in 1897. Ramakrishna mission was founded to carry the message and the thought of Sri Ramakrishna, spiritual guru of Swami Vivekananda. So remember here, Swami Vivekananda established Ramakrishna mission mainly intention of spreading the message and the thought of Sri Ramakrishna. So remember, he wanted to spread the message and the thought of Sri Ramakrishna. Swami Vivekananda was born in Calcutta and he studied both Western and Eastern philosophy. After understanding the Western and Eastern philosophy, he studied Indian philosophy from different perspectives. He started preaching the importance of Indian philosophy to Indians as well as Westerners. So first thing is remember, he studied both the philosophy, that is Western as well as Eastern philosophy. Then he studied the Indian philosophy in different perspectives, in different way. And then he started preaching about Indian philosophy to Indians, not only to Indians as well as to the Westerners. He opposed caste system, untouchability, and idea of supremacy based on caste system. He worked to establish a casteless society as he could see that society was deeply involved with caste-based discrimination. He also noticed exploitation of poverty, literacy, a division among the Indians. So remember children, these are the problem what he saw in our society. And the most important, he opposed three things. First, caste system. Second, untouchability. Third one, idea of supremacy based on caste system. That is, giving importance to one particular caste. As one particular caste was considered as superior. That he hated. Remember, three things he opposed. Caste system, untouchability, idea of supremacy based on caste system. And so remember, the next one is, he tried to get rid of most important social evil which is existing in our society was caste-based discrimination. He wants to get rid of it. So he decided, he worked to establish a casteless society. He also noticed exploitation of poverty, illiteracy, and division among Indians. So, exploitation of poverty, illiteracy, and division among Indians. Western could understand the cultural richness of India with the help of speech delivered by Swami Vivekananda at Chicago City in the World Religious Conference in 1893. He explained about our Indian culture in Chicago, which is located in USA, in the World Conference, in the World Religious Conference. He explained about the Indian culture richness, and he was appreciated for it, and the way he explained the Westerners could understand in a very simple way he explained it, and people in the Western were able to understand what he explained about. So remember, World Religious Conference in 1893, which was conducted at Chicago City, in that Swami Vivekananda delivered a speech regarding Indian culture, and the Westerners were able to understand what he was trying to say to them. Not only that, he attracted the attention of listeners by speaking at Congress of Religion and held at Paris in 1900. And most important, before going to Chicago, Swami Vivekananda had visited Chamarajavadiyar 10. The next. Now, as per the suggestion of Swami Vivekananda, Chamarajavadiyar 10 started the school for untouchable children. Swami Vivekananda wrote many books. Jainana Yoga, Raja Yoga, Karma Yoga, and Bhakti Yoga. These were the important books which was written by Swami Vivekananda. And he also gave importance to freedom struggle. He saw that freedom includes social equality also. not only getting a freedom for our country, we have to see that the Indians are treated equally in our country. That was his main intention. Social equality. He wants to give importance to social equality. Most important about Vivekananda, he knew that if he has to get rid of all these problems, he believed that people should be first educated. Then they themselves can seek reformation. And he wanted legal institution to implement appropriate rules to support reformation. So remember, he had listed out what are the changes he has to get in the society, and he believed that all those changes can be brought only through education. At the same time, he wanted legal institution to implement appropriate rules to support the reformation. Is that clear, children? Have you understood about Swami Vivekananda, who founded Ramakrishna Mission? And main intention of Swami Vivekananda to establish Ramakrishna Mission was to spread the message and the thought of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Observe this picture, children. Left side is Madam Blavatsky and Colonel Olcott. Theosophical Society was basically founded by Madam Blavatsky and Colonel H. S. Olcott. They came to Adyar near Madras and established the headquarters of Theosophical Society in 1886. You can say it established the head office of Theosophical Society in 1886. At the headquarters also you can mention it as. And the main aim of the society was comparative study of various religion, philosophies and science. And they also had another goal to discover indomitable spirit hidden in the human. It was declared that universal brotherhood is important. So remember, who founded Theosophical Society? Theosophical Society was founded by Madam Blavatsky and Colonel H.S. Olcott. And the headquarters is located at Adyar near Madras. And it was established in the year 1886. And the main aim of the society was to do a comparative studies of various religion, philosophy and science. Religions, philosophies and science. The most important person in Theosophical Society is also Annie Besant. So before learning about Annie Besant, Madam Blavatsky and H.S. Olcott also have played a very important role in Theosophical Society. This society took its basic principle from Hindu sacred scriptures like Veda, Upanishad and Vedanta philosophy. Whatever principles were set in these philosophy were adopted by the Theosophical Societies. And they tried to find the solution to the present problem by studying the ancient Indian thoughts, philosophies and theoretical ideas. Hence the society basically tried to reformation of Hindu religion. Interestingly, foreigners took more interest in this process, where the Theosophical was trying its best to get reformation in Hindu society. But you can see the foreigners also were taking interest in this process. Annie Besant. Annie Besant who played a very important role in Theosophical society. With the arrival of Irish lady Annie Besant in India by 1893, the movement of Theosophical society started to grow more. So she is a Irish lady who came to India in the year 1893 and played a very important role in Theosophical society. She arrived in India as a member of this society. She was born in 1847 and she became an active member of the society in 1889. And she had more knowledge regarding Vedanta philosophy. She advocated regarding Indian culture. So she advocated that Indian culture is far more superior to the Western culture, which is based on the materialism. So remember, she gave more importance to Indian culture. She also had a knowledge regarding Vedanta philosophy. This movement was Reformation movement of Hinduism. She also did a comparative studies of Hinduism and Buddhism. Her main intention was to get some changes in the Hindu society. So she made a comparative studies between Hinduism and Buddhism. Her greatest achievement was translating Bhagavad Gita into English language. And the next one, she was called as Shweta Saraswati. She wanted education for all. She opened schools. She started Central Hindu Banaras College in 1898. The same institution became a university due to the forethought of Madam Malavika in 1916, and she started two periodical, New India and Commonwealth. Annie Besant has started two periodicals, New India and Commonwealth. Remember, her main intention was to get changes in the Hindu society. So she made a comparative study between Hindu and Buddhism. And her greatest achievement was to translate Bhagavad Gita to English. She was also called as Shweta Saraswati. And she gave importance to education. She opened schools. And she started a college which was called Central Hindu Banaras College in the year 1898. And later this was converted into university due to forethought of Madan Mohana Malavika in 1816. And Annie Besant had started two periodicals, New India and Commonwealth. Annie Besant started Home Rule in 1916 and the Home Rule was initiated in Madras region. The credit of creating religious reformation movement and a sensibility for the society and its part and the parcel of Miss Annie Besant. She was active in freedom movement and became the first women president of Indian National Congress. Remember, the most important of movement which she started in the freedom struggle, during the freedom struggle, was Home Rule League in the year 1916. And that movement was started in Madras region. And next one, she played a creative role in religious reformation. She also took active part in the freedom movement and she was the first woman president of Indian National Congress. Sri Narayana Guru, who started a reformation movement in 1803. He started Sri Narayana Dharma Paripalana Yogam. Sri Narayana Dharma Paripalana Yogam. Sri Narayana Guru started reformation movement in 1903. This started Ishava of Kerala. He wanted to uplift these people. This movement aimed at strengthening the backward and exploited communities. Narayana Guru and his companion Dr. Palpu and Kumara Asan led this movement. There was too much of caste difference in Kerala. There were many prohibitions in places, and the lower caste people were not allowed to use a facility like tanks and roads, and they were also were not allowed to wear footwear. Restrictions were there on women's dress also. These community had to live without basic human right. So if you see, the lower caste people had suffered a lot in Kerala. And in Kerala, they gave more importance to caste system. And these are the examples. The lower caste people were not allowed to use tanks and roads. They were not even allowed to wear footwears. And restrictions were there on women's dress also. So overall, you can see that there was no human right followed in these communities. In order to address this issue, Sri Narayana Guru started Dharma Paripalana Yoga movement. According to this movement, one caste, one religion, and one God for human being was a basic idea of Sri Narayana Guru. And he knew that if he has to achieve, he has to give importance to education. Education is the only path to achieve this, he declared. He also built temples for the backward communities, as they were denied entry into the temples. The lower caste people were not allowed to enter the temples. Due to that, Sri Narayana Guru constructed a temple and allowed all the backward community to visit. Sri Narayana Guru and his companion started Vaikom movement, temple entry movement in 1924. Gandhiji and Periyar, the architect of self-respect movement, participated in this. The temple entry of Guruvayur temple was a major incident. So here the lower caste people also was allowed in the Guruvayur temple, and that was a major incident which took place during this movement. I remember Vaikom movement, it is a temple entry movement, and the architect of self-respect movement, Gandhiji and Periyar, also took part in this movement. Is that clear, children? The next, I will start with the next movement, Periyar. Periyar is the most important person who started non-Brahmin movement. About Periyar, we will learn now. In the beginning of 20th century, a Brahmin movement started in South India. The majority non-Brahmin launched agitation demanding representation in government sector as per their population. That means you can see non-Brahmin people are demanding a job in government sector. non-Brahminical communities oppose the restriction against them. That means the Brahmin communities opposed it. And this was possible due to the English education. And Periyar, the most important, he started Justice Party in the year 1916 and continued the movement in Tamil Nadu. Non-Brahmin movement took a new shape under the Justice Party. Justice Party was started by Periyar. And this became more radical. He started one more movement, Self-Respect Movement, which was led by E.V. Ramaswamy. He became a new force. Ramaswamy, who came out to the Congress in 1925, started Self-Respect League in 1926. He was called Periyar. Meaning of Periyar is senior person. He was called Periyar by the people. Periyar was born in Erode to a rich family. He believed that Congress in favor of Varna system. Varna system means caste system. And started a new movement based Dravida racial identity. He said Tamil is language of Dravidan. He championed equality and criticized caste and gender-based discrimination. He gave importance to equality and condemned caste system, gender-based discrimination. Two things he condemned. One was caste, the other one was gender-based discrimination. He gave more importance to equality. He also took part in Vaikom of Kerala, the Vaikom movement, which I've already mentioned in Sri Narayana Guru. So, Vaikom movement was started by Sri Narayana Guru, and in that, Periyar also participated. And this movement is connected to entry of low caste people in temple. And Vaikom was started in Kerala. He became the president of Justice Party in 1939. He started an association called Dravida Kalagam. He also started Justice Periodical. So remember, he started the Justice Party, and later in 1939 he became the president of Justice Party. He started an association which was called Dravida Kalagam. He also started Justice Periodical. Periyar remained as ideological symbol in Tamil Nadu politics. This is more evident in all the political party of Tamil Nadu retaining the word Dravida with their names. The ideological non-Brahmin movement started by T.M. Nair was turned into a culture movement by Periyar. His life goal was to establish an equal society where there will be no inequality based on caste, religion, gender. So remember children, the most important, Periyar's main aim or goal was to establish an equal society. People should not be divided in the name of caste, religion, gender. He wanted everyone in the society to be treated equally. That was his main intention. He started non-Brahmin movement. With that, he established a party called Justice Party. And the most important, he started an association called Dravida Kalagam. And you can see, even today, in all the Tamil Nadu political parties have maintained this word Dravida. So next, we will start with the assignment now. The first question is regarding, explain how Swami Vivekananda was a source of inspiration for youngsters. Here you have to mention Swami Vivekananda, how he brought the changes among the youngsters, how he was an inspiration for the youngsters. So you people have to write these points in that. First one is, remember, where was Swami Vivekananda born? He was born in Calcutta. He studied both the philosophy, that was Eastern and Western philosophy. After that, he studied the Indian philosophy in a different perspectives. He started preaching the importance of Indian philosophy to Indians as well as Westerners. And he was the founder of Ramakrishna Mission, who tried to spread the message and the thoughts of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Swami Vivekananda wanted to establish a casteless society. So you will write all these to mean he wanted to establish a casteless society. From here you have to write the how he gave importance for education. About the detailing you will write it, children. The next one is regarding what were the reformation activity of Annie Besant? What are the changes she brought in the society? About that, you people have to mention here. The first one is regarding, you have to mention when she came to India, then she joined in Theosophical Society and played an important role, and she was responsible for gaining an importance in Theosophical Society. And she made a comparative studies between Hindu and Buddhism. And she translated Bhagavad Gita to English. And next one, what was the title given to her? It was Shweta Saraswati. She established a college, Central Hindu College at Banaras. And you also have to mention two periodicals she had started, New India and Commonwealth. And with that, you have to mention detail about home rule and freedom struggle. Next one is, third question is regarding Sri Narayana Dharma Paripalana Yogam. About this society, about these reformation, you have to explain here. So remember, Sri Narayana Dharma Paripalana Yogam was started by Sri Narayana Guru, and his main intention to get social reform in Kerala. And mainly which group he wants to get the changes, you have to mention that. And moreover, you have to mention what are the movement he started in Kerala and who took part in that movement. And you have to mention he constructed a temple, and he was the first person to see that the lower caste people were allowed to get into the temple. Is that clear, Shri? These are the points what you have to write in Sri Narayana Dharma Paripalana Yogam. Thank you, children. And this is the end of this lesson. And next session, I'll be starting with the new lesson. Thank you, children.